हेलो एंड वेलकम टू हॉकफीड न्यूज़। रिसेंटली फॉर्मर उत्तर प्रदेश शिया सेंट्रल वक्फ बोर्ड चेयरमैन वसीम रिजवी हैज़ डन अ मैग्निफिशेंट घर वापसी टू एम्ब्रेस हिंदुइज्म विच इज़ सनातन धर्म। हाउएवर एवर सिंस वसीम रिजवी हैज़ कन्वर्टेड टू सनातन धर्म और से क्विट इस्लाम टू बिकम जितेंद्र नारायण सिंह त्यागी, द फ्यूम्ड इस्लामिस्ट पेशेंस इज रनिंग थिन and they have begun targeting him and calling him a kafir. Now can you just imagine that? Now Wasim Rizvi, after reverting back to Sanatan Dharma, because you know it is once said by the great master of the masters Zakir Naik himself, he said that all our ancestors were Hindus. You must have seen that viral video on internet. Anyways, Wasim Rizvi, after reverting to Sanatan Dharma, asserted that I was removed from Islam, the prize money on my head is increasing every Friday. Today I am embracing Sanatan Dharma. Earlier, a video was released in which Wasim can be seen expressing his wish to be cremated as a Hindu. Now, when he wanted himself to be cremated according to the Hindu rituals instead of Muslim customs, this also sparked a fume among the Islamists of India. Now, explaining the method of his funeral, he had also asserted that his body should be burnt and not buried, which itself is a very big statement. Now, while the Muslims of this country may not be liking this idea, and some of them are also calling a bounty on his head. Now, let me tell you that he also mentioned that his pyre must be lit by a Hindu friend, Mahant Narsinghanand Giriji. Now, you can understand when he says Mahant Narsinghanand Saraswati Ji, who is from Dasna Temple of Ghaziabad, it makes a big impact because Narsinghanand Saraswati is living in an area which is known as Dasna, which is located in Ghaziabad, and Dasna area has more than 90% Muslim population. Now, the big question is, if Narsinghanand becomes his mentor, fumed by Rizvi's ghar vapsi to embrace Hinduism, Islamists attack him on social media. The community also threatened to behead him. A Twitter user, Majid BNR, wrote, "We didn't consider him as a Muslim when he publicly insulted the holy book and prophet before accepting Hindu religion. Religion not comes from DNA, dear." Now, the flag that you see on social media right now against Wasim Rizvi, it is quite understood. People are not able to digest it. In addition to the tweets, a 10-day-old video is circulating across the social media in which Hyderabad Congress leader Firoz Khan can be seen announcing a rupees 50 lakh bounty for whoever beheads ex-UP Shia board chief Wasim Rizvi. Now you can clearly see in that video on the background that he is using a Congress poster and he is using a derogatory and a violent language against Wasim Rizvi. The Congress leader said, "Wasim Rizvi, I have been hearing you for the last 4 months. You have crossed all the limits. Wherever one spots him, just kill him. Get his severed head to me and in return take rupees 50 lakhs from me. Whoever kills him, I will help him fight his case, be it in the Sessions Court, High Court or the Supreme Court, everywhere. My lawyer would represent you and I will provide you with full support." Now you can understand what kind of a language, what kind of a message this Congress leader wants to send to his audience, to his followers.
Wasim Rizvi, 4 months se sun rahe the tujhko main, bardasht jo hai na tu khatam kar dega. Inhe jahan bhi dikha iska murder kar do, aur iska gala le leke mere paas aa jao, 50 lakh rupaye mere se le lena. और जो भी इसका मर्डर कर रहा, सेशन कोर्ट हो, हाई कोर्ट हो, सुप्रीम कोर्ट हो, हर जगह वकील मैं रखूंगा, तेरा साथ मैं दूंगा. ऐसे हराम के पिल्ले को और ऐसे सुगर की औलाद को कोई जीने का इख्तियार नहीं है. जो भी मैं कुछ सुन रहा, मैं अल्लाह की कसम खा रहा हूं, मैं तेरा साथ दूंगा. जय हिंद, शुक्रिया, अल्लाह हाफिज.
He is clearly giving a message to cause violence. Now, when Rizvi filed a petition in the Supreme Court seeking to remove 26 verses of the Quran, alleging that it promoted terrorism and jihad, the Muslim clerics had issued a bounty over of like rupees 20,000 for anyone who brought Rizvi's head to them. However, the man whose reputation had taken a nosedive for churning terrorists and extremists who are misguided, so-called misguided by them and by the misinterpretation of the Quran, is now back to Sanatan Dharma and needs to be supported for the same. Obviously, it's time that people support Wasim Rizvi, or call him Jitendra Narayan Singh Tyagi, but it's time that people start supporting Wasim, because he is one of those rare people who have come out and actually, you know, spoken out the truth. Another big news is coming. Prime Minister Narendra Modi handed over the indigenous light combat helicopter to the Indian Air Force during the National Defence Surrender Ceremony held in Jhansi to commemorate the 75th year of the Indian independence. IAF Chief Air Chief Marshal Vivek Ram Chaudhary symbolically received the IAF LCH in the presence of several dignitaries after the Kargil War of 1999, the need for an effective helicopter to carry out precision strikes at high altitude was felt by the Indian Air Force. However, all these years, there was no such major progress in this field. But as you can see, keeping this in mind, the design and development of an indigenously built and light combat helicopter was approved by the Government of India in the October 2006. However, it took a long time because of the red tapeism which exists in this country. However, Hindustan Aeronautics Limited undertook the task to dedicate this resource towards the national interest. With their dedication and tireless hard work, HAL accomplished this adventure, although it has taken a long time if you compare it with other Western developed countries. However, any success is a success. The Indian Air Force then conveyed its requirement to the government in an official program held in December 2013, in which a total of 160 LCHs were sought. Now, HAL is committed to producing 30 helicopters per year, keeping in view this demand of the army as well. The twin-engine LCH in the 5 to 8 ton weight class is the only attack helicopter in the world that can take off and land at an altitude of 5,000 meters or 16,400 feet with a massive amount of weapons and fuel. Along with this, it can fly up to a height of 15 to 16,000 feet. It is also effective in temperatures ranging from minus 50 degree on snow tops to 50 degree in the desert. So you can imagine what kind of a capacity this light helicopter has. And it's the only aircraft to land in inhospitable battlefields such as Siachen. Equipped with air-to-air and air-to-surface missiles, this LCH is fitted with a 20mm gun, 70mm rocket, and also an air-to-air missile. Combined with its avionics and arm, it can find and destroy any enemy target, whether in the air or on the ground. So that's about this LCH. And also, let me tell you that this attack helicopter is operated manually during the mission. It can be erected at 180 degrees and can be turned upside down if needed. It can spin 360 degrees, which means it can spin quickly and change its course in the air, which makes it invincible for a dogfight. Now you can imagine what kind of a capacity this light combat helicopter has. Or let me also tell you that India is surrounded by enemies from all directions. India shares inhospitable borders with these enemies. You know, let me name these countries: China and Pakistan, of course. And also, you cannot undermine the threat from Bangladesh as well. Now, these borders are likely to turn into battlefields going forward, whether it is Kargil or Doklam. India has always felt the need for an advanced and light fighter aircraft. The fulfillment of these requirements was visible on 12th of August 2020, when the Indian Air Force was deployed two LCH prototypes in Ladakh to conduct armed patrols from forward air bases. Specifically, for high altitude operations, a large portion of any aircraft or helicopter is made of composite materials and metals, such as titanium, to withstand the exposure to extreme temperatures and the environment. This makes the machine expensive but capable of operating, and that too with high payloads from high altitude bases. LCH is truly a gem for Indian indigenous defense manufacturing capacity. As you can see, now India's own indigenous defense manufacturing capacity is increasing day by day, and India is becoming one of those countries that is now becoming gradually independent when it comes to India's armed needs. If you like the video, please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. Thank you and Jai Hind.